네, 잠시 안내 말씀드리겠습니다. 잠시 후부터 오늘 개막의 시작을 알릴 개막 공연이 진행될 예정입니다. 내외빈 여러분들께서는 자리에 착석해 주시기 바랍니다.
In just a moment, the opening ceremony of the 2022 FIATA Busan World Congress will commence. We would greatly appreciate it if you would take your seats at this time. Now for the opening performance to kick off the 2022 FIATA Busan World Congress, please welcome the Busan Metropolitan Dance Company as they perform Korea Fantasy.
Ha,
네, 부산 시립 무용단의 멋진 공연입니다. 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Thank you once again for that wonderful performance by the Busan Metropolitan Dance Company.
네, 그럼 지금부터 2022 국제물류협회 부산 세계총회 개막식을 시작하도록 하겠습니다.
We will now officially begin the opening ceremony of the 2022 FIATA Busan World Congress.
네, 만나서 대단히 반갑습니다. 저는 2022 국제물류협회 피아타 부산 세계총회 진행을 맡은 박은경입니다. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 2022 피아타 부산 World Congress. I'm 은경 박, your MC. I would like to thank you your presence with us today.
And my name is Ju Chinam, and it's an honor and pleasure to be your co-host of this very wonderful World Congress.
네, 2022 국제물류협회 피아타 부산 세계총회는 전 세계 물류산업의 인사들이 모여 주요 이슈들을 되돌아보고 각 분야의 전문가로서 물류산업에 대해서 전망하고 고견을 나누는 장입니다.
This particular World Congress looks back on major issues, forecasts, and shares expert opinions from each field.
네, 특히 물류 분야의 기업인은 물론 정관계의 많은 인사분들께서 참석해 주셨으며 올해는 전 세계 전문가분들께서 참석하셔서 피아타를 통한 국제적인 네트워킹 기회의 확장이 기대되고 있습니다.
It is a very special venue that provides quality networking opportunities with industry experts and we are enjoying an incredible turnout this year.
네, 피아타를 통한 글로벌 물류 산업 확대 및 세계 경제 활성화를 주제로 기념 영상을 준비해 봤는데요. 지금부터 함께 만나보시도록 하겠습니다.
We will now view a commemorative video on the subject of expanding the global logistics industry and revitalizing the global economy through FIATA.
Logistics, the blood vessels of the global economy. The history of roads paved the way for civilizations and advancement of mankind. But this road of glory is filled with scars of the pains of the past. No longer a path of war and conflict, but a road to prosperity and coexistence. A journey that will illuminate the future of international cooperation. For mutual prosperity and robust development. Whenever you glide through the seas, whenever you soar through the skies, the 2,000 logistics experts from 150 different countries are with you. Challenges faced by the world. Tasks we must resolve. The global supply chain crisis, declining efficiency in airport operation, and increase in freight rates. The challenges we must overcome amidst the rapidly changing society. Opportunities and strategies to rise to the changes in global trade. The center of Northeast Asia, Korea. The International Logistics Powerhouse. Go beyond cooperation to create value in Busan, the logistics port city. FIATA 2022.
Ne, 박수가 절로 나오고 있네요. 이 자리에 계신 모든 분들이 물류 산업의 발전과 세계 경제 활성화의 실현에 앞장서시는 주역이십니다.
We sincerely applaud all the great leaders present here today who are instrumental in the development of the logistics industry worldwide. You are truly the drivers of the global economy.
네, 모두 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Another round of big applause for them.
네, 오늘 2022 국제물류협회 부산 세계총회 개막식에 바쁘신 와중에도 개막식을 축하해 주시기 위해서 많은 내외 기빈 여러분들께서 자리해 주셨습니다. 제가 한 분 한 분 소개해 드릴 때마다 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
We would like to recognize all the distinguished guests who are here today. We truly appreciate your presence who have attended this World Congress as a show of support despite their busy schedules. First and foremost, I'd like to introduce the president of FIATA, President Ivan Petrov.
네, 이반 페트로프 피아타 회장님 자리하셨습니다. 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다. 네, 다음으로 피아타 2022 김병진 조직 위원장님 자리하셨습니다.
And Chairman Kim Byung-jin of the 2022 FIATA Organizing Committee.
네, 2022 피아타 부산 세계총회 공동 조직 위원장이신 부산광역시 박형준 시장님 자리하셨습니다.
Mayor Park Hyung-jun of Busan Metropolitan City and also the co-chair of the FIATA Organizing Committee.
원희룡 국토교통부 장관님 자리하셨습니다. 큰 박수 부탁드립니다.
Also Minister 원희룡 of the Ministry of Land, Infrastructure and Transport.
백종헌 국회의원님 자리하셨습니다.
Also National Assemblyman 백종헌 as well. And the former FIATA president, Mr. Basil Peterson, is also with us today.
바질 피터슨, 피아타 전임 회장님 자리해 주셨습니다. 네, 다음으로 한국국제물류협회 원재철 회장님 함께 하셨습니다. 큰 박수 부탁드립니다.
Also, President 원재철 of the Korea International Freight Forwarders Association.
김병석 한국건설기술연구원 원장님 자리하셨습니다.
President Kim Byung-seok of Korea Institute of Civil Engineering and Building Technology.
네, 김세현 전 국회의원님 자리하셨습니다.
And former National Assemblyman Mr. Kim Se-hyun as well.
이재근 전 국회의원님 함께 해주셨습니다.
And former National Assemblyman Mr. 이재근.
박승환 전 국회의원님 자리해 주셨습니다.
And former National Assemblyman Mr. 박승환.
네, 다음으로 설동근 전 교육감님 함께 해 주셨습니다.
And also the Korea Education Superintendent Mr. 설동근 as well.
도덕희 한국해양대학교 총장님 자리해 주셨습니다.
President 도덕희 of the Korea Maritime and Ocean University.
최윤희 대한민국 해양연맹 총재님 자리하셨습니다.
And President 최윤희 of the Sea Power League of the Republic of Korea.
김종덕 한국해양수산개발원 원장님 자리하셨습니다.
President 김종덕 of the Korea Maritime Institute.
네, 다음으로 여수광양항만공사 박성빈 사장님 자리하셨습니다.
And Chairman 박성빈 of the 여수광양 Port Authority.
신한춘 한국자유총연맹 부산시지부 회장님 자리하셨습니다.
Chairman 신한춘 of Korea Freedom Federation.
네, 마지막으로 서정의 대한적십자 부산지사 회장님 자리하셨습니다.
And also Chairman 서정의 of Busan Red Cross is with us today.
네, 오늘의 귀한 자리를 빛내주신 내외 기빈 여러분들께 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Let's give them a big round of applause one more time for your presence this morning.
다음 순서로 피아타 이반 페트로프 회장님의 환영사가 있겠습니다.
Next, Mr. Ivan Petrov, President Petrov of FIATA will deliver his welcoming remarks.
네, 여러분 큰 박수로 환영해 주시기 바랍니다.
Please give him a big round of applause.
Distinguished FIATA friends, yes, FIATA as well. 안녕하세요. Welcome to FIATA World Congress. It's a real new phase of FIATA development since we have suffered this COVID interruption for such a period of time, and we meet us 3 years later than the previous Congress. It never happened. So this disruption is for us very important to be overcome, and this was our gesture to come and make continuation of our life, of our logistics world. What we did in this period, you know, we started the reset program as from 19, and we entered into FIATA into a new chapter. There is a big progress in FIATA divisions, in structural way we put our organization, a digitalization division, training and development, membership and growth, and marketing and events. We have a big media report outcome, like having our image into the global world much more visible than before, and recognition among all different organizations in Geneva, in globally governmental and also non-governmental. We have discussed recently our new statement on FIATA mission, vision, values, and we want to share it with you. It's not a set values only process, it's a process we have in the working process now, and we'll go further on with this. So the FIATA statement, mission statement is, FIATA is the largest federation and voice of the global logistics serving its entire ecosystem. It is fostering the knowledge of its members to ensure a sustainable and resilient supply chain. You see how many words each fits to a special moment. Vision, logistics without borders for a digital and sustainable world. This matches so much to the slogan of the Congress we are opening now. Very, very much. And we value excellence, integrity, trust, inclusion, and responsibility. We are here included, really. That's one of the values. What we did recently either, we launched and we are gonna launch electronic FIATA bill of lading as the trustful multimodal and negotiable document in multimodal set of transport here in Korea. And this would be a really great chance for improvement of the setup of the possibilities within the whole ecosystem of logistics within Korea. And we know how important logistics for Korea is, which is one of the leading countries worldwide. We promoted freight pay as a system to payments between freight forwarders, as well as members registry to be sure that we are a trustful organization and any document issued here is really registered and is trustful. We have a very nice and got a very nice and legal commercial practices enlargement within the last few years, supporting members with policy making papers, with position papers. We have advocacy. That's very important for international organization global to have advocacy all over the world and to be admitted by other stakeholders. And what we are going to show you, it's the Maritime Crisis Task Force and the webinar series, and we shall have such again here in Korea, since this is a big disruption in our global world, the maritime crisis that we passed into after COVID or during the COVID period. So we also try and continue to go globally to fit ourselves into global environment, not only as an English-speaking organization, which is quite normal, but to fit to specific standards of the local languages, which are for important languages in the world. And just as an example, just recently translated into Chinese ABLM best practice guide for abandoned goods. Of course, it's everything is English, based, but translations would be more in the future, so why not in Korean? Because I see Here is the amount of English is not that large, so it might be very good if we have been working good with Kifa, Mr. Kim, and we make it through your help. Why not? So there are a lot of things that we can improve, we can do, and all this, our distinguished excellencies here on the first rows, as well as all this big audience is very welcome to contribute to our work and to recognize a big role that FIATA has in the field of international logistics now. Kamsahamnida.
Thank you so much, President Petra, for your warm remarks.
네, 좋은 말씀 해주신 이반 페트로프 회장님께 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Thank you.
네, 본행사는 동시통역 수신기가 제공되고 있습니다. 한국어 채널은 1번이며 영어는 2번이니 참고해 주시기 바랍니다.
Please be reminded that translation device is provided, so if you require one, please ask for one. And English is channel 1 and Korean is channel 2.
네, 이어서 FIATA 202 김병진 조직위원장님의 환영사가 있겠습니다.
Next Chairman Kim Byung-jin of the 2022 FIATA Organizing Committee will deliver his welcoming remarks.
네, 여러분 다시 한번 뜨거운 박수로 맞이해 주시기 바랍니다.
Please give him a hearty applause as he approaches the stage.
Good morning, all FIATA members and ladies and gentlemen. It's my great honor to have His Excellency, Minister of Land of Transport, Mr. Won Hee-ryong, and Parliament and Baek Jong-hun, former parliamentarians, and Kim Se-hyun, Lee Jae-kyung. This time is very, thank you very much. FIATA members and congratulate 2022 FIATA World Congress in Busan today. My special thanks always go to the Mayor of Busan, Mr. Park Hyung-jun, co-chair of organizing and committee of the Congress. I would like to my sincere thanks and Iban presidents and former president Bajer and my older brothers in Isabaluchi and Stanley Lim. Okay, thank you. And the honorary members and Isabaluchi and Stanley Lim and the senior vice president and Tugu Thomas Sim and Jens Roma, and member of FIATA board and participant from Asia, Europe, Africa, and Americas. I would like to express my special thanks to the Korean government side, the city of Busan, as well as the many sponsoring organizations and the companies for their help in preparing for the 2022 FIATA World Congress in Busan. I would like to ask you to join me to close the online and offline to celebrate the opening of the 2022 FIATA World Congress in Busan with a round applause. FIATA voice speaks and for the entire global logistics industry through the Korea International Logistics Forum and global sessions, exhibitions, and B2B meetings, including in the World Congress, I hope you will have a meaningful experience here in my hometown, Busan. At the beginning, I believe mentioned my relationship with the PR of the past 8 years. The World Congress was postponed for 2 years due to COVID-19. But all this adversity served as process experience, the hard work has paid off. This experience will not only be limited to the Busan World Congress, but also serve a step forward to discovering sustainable solutions that can contribute to the region and the country, bring together industry, research organizations, and public institutions, and carrying out tasks that contribute to international agendas. Going forward, I ask you humbly for your continued interest and support. Thank you very much.
네, 김병진 조직위원장님께 뜨거운 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Thank you once again, Chairman Kim, for your kind remarks.
피아타 부산 세계총회를 고향인 부산에 유치하기까지 정말 많은 노력을 기울이신 걸로 알고 있습니다. 다시 한번 뜨거운 박수 보내주시기 바랍니다.
I know you made diligent efforts to make this Congress possible in the city of Busan. Thank you once again.
네, 다음 순서는 2022 피아타 부산 세계총회 공동조직위원장이신 박형준 부산광역시장님의 환영사가 있겠습니다.
Next, we'll hear from Mayor Park Hyung-jun of Busan Metropolitan City, as well as the co-chair of the committee, organizing committee of this World Congress.
네, 뜨거운 박수로 환영해 주시기 바랍니다.
Please give him a big round of applause.
They asked me to speak in Korean, but now the prompter shows me an English version. Then I will follow the English version. 여러분 안녕하십니까? 오늘 참석해 주신 FIATA 회원 여러분.
The world who are visiting Busan. The 2022 FIATA Wood Congress is finally able to be held after a two-year absence due to the COVID-19 pandemic. I wish to express my sincere gratitude to President Ivan Petrov and Chairperson of the Organizing Committee, Kim Byung-jin, for their kind support and successfully hosting this event even in the face of such difficulties. Especially, I also thank for visiting here to Minister of Land and Transportation Department, Won Hiryong, and the Won Jae-chul, the President of Korea Logistics Association. Logistics is the driving force behind the world economy. Logistics took control of the wheel of human history from the era of barter trade in ancient times to the overwhelmingly advanced logistics technology we use today. During the course of the last 100 years, FIATA has played a pivotal role in developing the world logistics industry. I wish to extend my deepest respect for your hard work and great achievement over such a long time. I hope the 2022 FIATA World Congress in Busan will be a golden opportunity to open up a new stage for the world logistics industry. Matching the event's theme of uniting for global solutions, it is highly expected that this Congress will be a very meaningful occasion to suggest new future possibilities for the industry on the cusp of the great transformation era. Korea has undertaken a long journey to become an open trade nation, and Busan has been a major driving force behind the country's success. The Busan port has become the second largest transshipment and the seventh largest international trade port through its continuous development since opening 146 years ago. Beyond shipping and logistics, Busan is also a tri-port city equipped with an international airport and railway. The city aims to take the next leap forward to become a full sword of culture edgy multimodal logistics in the world once. Busan New Port is connected with the Gadokdo New International Airport after its completion. Beyond this, when the era of Northport route begins, Busan will gain even bigger wings. The city is committed to becoming a global logistics hub city like Singapore and Hong Kong by specializing in the digital finance industry as well as logistics. Busan is exerting an all-out effort to host the 2030 World Expo. The World Expo has a great venue for the festival, which will embrace universal values worthy of a universal civilization and state-of-the-art technology and culture realized by those values. If Busan hosts the 2030 World Expo, it will provide a great opportunity to further develop the world logistics industry. I cordially ask for your kind support for Busan to help win the bid for the 2030 World Expo. The city is a genuine tourist city with beautiful nature and a safe environment, where tourists and citizens are able to freely enjoy beautiful beaches, night views, and experience a variety of tourist attractions from early morning to late at night. I hope you can fully enjoy the many charms of the city during your stay. In closing, I hope this Congress will bring significant achievements. And once again, I wish to extend my heartfelt welcome to all the distinguished guests to Busan. Thank you so much.
네, 환영의 마음 가득 담아 인사 말씀 전해주신 박형준 시장님께 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Thank you so much, Mayor Park, for your warm and kind remarks.
네, 아울러 2030 월드 엑스포도 꼭 부산에 유치되기를 한 마음으로 기원하겠습니다.
Yeah, we'd like to provide all the support and love we can for the World Expo 2030 in the hopes of achieving that promise here in Busan.
네, 감사합니다. 마지막 순서로 원희룡 국토교통부 장관님의 치사가 있겠습니다.
Last but not least, Minister Won Hee-ryong of the Ministry of Land, Infrastructure and Transport will provide us his remarks.
네, 귀한 걸음 해주신 원희룡 장관님께 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Please give him a big round of applause once again as he approaches the stage.
2 versions.
네.
Korean and English. Actually, yeah. Busan Mayor Park and I promised to deliver our messages by Korean. So it's my turn to deliver my message by Korean. You could use the simultaneous interpreter.
Good morning. 2022 FIATA World Congress in Busan.
Busan 갈매기.
I am the beloved Busan Seagull. I extend my heartfelt congratulations on the hosting of the 2022 FIATA World Congress in Busan. I would like to thank Mr. Ivan Petrov, President of FIATA, Mr. Kim Byung-jin, Chairman of the 2022 FIATA Organizing Committee, and Mr. Won Jae-chul, Chairman of KIFA, for making this event possible. In particular, I would like to acknowledge Mr. Park Hyung-jun, Mayor of Busan Metropolitan City and Co-Chair of the 2022 FIATA Organizing Committee, for all his support, and Member of the National Assembly, Mr. Baek Jong-hun, for taking the time to grace us with his presence despite the busy schedules at the legislature. The FIATA World Congress brings together the global logistics professionals to the world's largest international logistics event. The international logistics industry now faces a new environment with a surge in cargo traffic and a crisis in the supply chain. This World Congress is held with the theme Uniting for Global Solutions Against This Backdrop of Rapidly Changing Environment. We will share best practices among companies and have vibrant discussions on developing a new logistics network. And through this, I hope that we can reach many practical answers and solutions to further developing the international logistics. International logistics enable global communication and connection through trade as the artery of the global economy. The Korean government will provide unsparing support to Korean logistics companies so that they become competitive enough to lead the global market. To this end, the government will secure infrastructure, including distribution centers at key areas in and out of Korea, and enhance the capabilities of air and sea transportation. By the year's end, the government will also establish an overseas logistics information center to share information on international logistics in real time and expand startup support and talent development. Ladies and gentlemen, the host city of this year's World Congress, Busan, is bidding to host the 2030 World Expo. All the citizens of Busan have come together to win the bid. As the minister overseeing the infrastructure of this country, and on behalf of the ROK government, I will make my best efforts for Busan to win the bid and host a successful expo. In particular, Busan will have my full support in improving its key logistics infrastructure, such as airports and railways, to catapult into an international logistics hub. I ask you for your interest and support for Busan's successful bid to host the 2030 World Expo. I ask all the member countries of FIATA to send us your biggest support. In closing, I would like to convey my warmest welcome and sincere gratitude to you all for attending the World Congress, and I wish you successful outcomes and all the happiness in your days to come. Thank you very much.
네, 너무나 좋은 말씀 감사합니다. 원희룡 장관님께 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Thank you so much, Minister Won, for your kind remarks.
네. 장관님의 이 치사가 나오는 도중에 정말 많은 박수가 나왔습니다. 피아타 세계 총회의 성공적인 개최와 그리고 이런 진행뿐만이 아니라 2030 월드 엑스포에 대해서도 큰 기대와 또 지원을 아끼지 않겠다고 말씀해 주셨는데요. 다시 한번 감사드립니다.
Thank you, Minister Wan, for your kind remarks as we're preparing for the World Expo of 2030 here in Busan. All of his support as well as your support would be greatly appreciated.
네, 다시 한번 뜨거운 박수 부탁드릴까요?
One more big round of applause.
네, 다음 순서는 기조강연이 준비되어 있습니다. 전중헌 OECD 산업자문위원회 위원님의 기조강연이 준비되어 있습니다. 네, 본 강연에서는 동시통역 수신기를 이용하실 수 있는데요. 한국어 채널은 1번, 영어 채널은 2번으로 준비가 되고 있습니다.
Next is our keynote speaker, Dr. 전중헌 of the Committee Representative of OECD Digital Economy and Technology Innovation. For those who require translation, please use the translation device. English channel 2 and Korean channel 1.
Hi everyone. Good morning. My name is James Chun and it's my honor to be a keynote speaker on this opening session. In the light of a main subject, uniting the global solution, I would like to talk the insight regarding the impact of COVID-19 and digitalization on international trade and global value chains in terms of a digital economy. In addition to that, as a hosting country, I would like to give the moment how original Korean language sounds so beautiful. Accordingly, I will speak in Korean. You will hear Korean and English simultaneously. So let me start.
before I begin, let me briefly introduce myself. I am an OECD Korean representative of the Committee of Digital Economy of the OECD. I am also serving as the chair of Digital Finance Center, and I am the CEO of Arihash Global Partners. From 1997 through 2018, I worked as an Asia Pacific regional leader and the current CEO of Country Representative Director of Hewlett Packard. And I also I'm serving as the representatives of various organizations. So I think two words that represent me is digital and global trade and global transactions. So this is my agenda. And before I joined and came onto the podium, I was asked to finish my presentation in 2 minutes' time for the photo session. So I will be quite brief and to the point. And as for the remaining insight, we can share later. Then for the global value chains and international trade, how is the status of digitalization? When we talk about digitalization, the first step is digitize, which is turning analog data into digital data. The second is digitalize, that is to turn that data into big data. And the third step or phase is digital transformation, that is to use the digital technology such as IoT, artificial intelligence, and big data for digital transformation. I believe international logistics and global value chain are in the stage of a digital transformation. Then the big data in the middle, what is it? There are three basic factors. The first is scale of data. Well, the data should be in the quantity of terabyte unit. So you should have the volume and you should have the velocity for the analysis of real-time data or streaming data. And you also need to have variety, which means the different forms of data. In addition to that, you also need to address uncertainty of data through veracity, and you should be able to ensure value of data so that you can be assisted with the big data and the digital transformation and technology for the decision making down the road. So there are five V's for big data. So, and I believe the big data is is the very important lens for us to look into global logistics and global value chains. The pandemic had massive and varied impact on demand, supply, and international trade associated with larger shifts in trade volumes and values. And you know, we have had such a severe crisis, global financial crisis, back in 2008 and 2009. However, this time, the speed and the pace of recovery was really rapid and compressed. Well, it took 3 years for the global financial crisis to full the recovery, but in a matter of 6 months in this time of the pandemic, the recovery took place. Another difference here is that as compared to the global financial crisis, after or during the COVID-19, the regional synchronization, the level of regional synchronization was very small and limited. And China was very outstanding in terms of the recovery. So taking a look at the export status throughout the globe, we can see, well, the trade, the trend is more or less the same between the COVID-19, the pandemic, and the global financial crisis. And then what is the difference? That is mainly due to the global value chain. And in the global trade and logistics and global value chain, we can see the impact of digitalization. Well, that we can see the consumers' digitalization and global logistics systems' global digitalization. So this digital transformation has reduced the cost of engaging in international trade and logistics. China has been serving as one of the most important hubs in the global value chain, and the United States and China have registered significant growth. If you compare 2016 and 2022, the cross-border commerce market has grown by 5 times.
Next, during the pandemic, if we look at the efficiency and risk of GVC, efficiencies include specialization, comparative advantage, and scale, economy of scale, and reduced production price. And also there are opportunities for small players, but there are also risks. Because of the high reliance on global hubs that play a big role in the value chain, this leads to greater exposure to shocks. For example, there's a global facial mask demand and supply issue, but in the interest of time, I will skip this. And through this process, the OECD wanted to take a look at a comparison between interconnected regimes of GVCs versus localized regimes to see what offers greater benefits. And I have 3 insights that we got from the model at the bottom of the slide. In 3 aspects, the localized value chains offer less benefit than GVC, and it is better for most countries to use the GVC in terms of level and stability of economic activity. So based on all this, the OECD presents 3 policy recommendations. The government must work closely with firms and private sector associations in order to prepare for risk ahead of the risk. And secondly, we need to take action to ensure supply of essential goods, and we need to calibrate and also harmonize the norms and standards and also regulations. So in the end, the global value chain, and we in the global value chain, we need to maximize efficiency and minimize risk by working with the government and the private sector, in particular with the private sector associations such as FIATA. And with that, I would like to conclude my short speech. And as for the appendix on the OECD Going Digital projects, please refer to the materials later on. I wish you a good photo session. Thank you.
네, 멋진 기조 강연을 전해주신 전중권 위원님께 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Dr. Kwon, thank you so much for your wonderful welcoming remarks and your keynote presentation.
네, 오늘 정말 많은 분들께서 이 기조 강연에 공감하셨을 것 같습니다. 다음 순서는 내빈 여러분들의 단체 기념 촬영이 준비가 되어 있는데요. 앞서 1열에 앉으신 18분의 내빈 분들께서는 안내에 따라서 무대 위로 함께 자리해 주시기 바랍니다.
We will now have a group photo session of all the distinguished guests, but we will first begin with the center row of 18 guests first come up to the stage at this time.
네, 지금 현재 일렬에 중앙에 계신 내빈 여러분들께서 자리해 주셨고요. 바로 양 옆에 앉으신 18분의 내빈분들께서도 함께 안내에 따라서 무대 위로 자리해 주시기 바랍니다.
And our distinguished guests to the left and to the right of our stage, may all of you come to the stage for the group photo session at this time.
FIATA 2022 부산 세계총회가 성공적으로 개최되길 바라는 마음을 담아서 오른손을 들고 제가 하나 둘 셋 하면 화이팅 외쳐보도록 하겠습니다. 하트로 할까요?
하트로 네. Okay. Yeah, that's a very traditional Korean way of presenting your mini heart.
Yes, 마스크 밖으로도 비춰지는 환한 미소 보여주셨습니다. 큰 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Thank you so much for your kind presence.
네, 이것으로 2022 국제물류협회 부산 세계총회 개막식을 마치도록 하겠습니다.
This concludes the opening ceremony of the 2022 FIATA Busan World Congress.
네, 자리해 주신 내빈 여러분 및 참석자 여러분들께서는 퇴장하실 때 안내 데스크에 꼭 동시통역 수신기를 반납해 주시면 감사하겠습니다.
We would greatly appreciate it if you would return.